He's a man who's charted a new aggressive course in the Indian retail space, and he's done it his way. Today, Kishore Biyani's Future Group straddles businesses across the retail chain, from rural distribution to high-profile brands. But despite the formidable reputation he has built, India's retail king hasn't had a good experience with investors in India's stock market. And his latest venture, one he's particularly proud of, Future Ventures, has also seen a very tough debut. So what has gone wrong?
It's one of the most finer and interesting creations. We believe it's capturing the spirit of India. It's capturing the spirit of the new consumption which is going to happen. And it is placing its bets on the consumer goods industry. And we understand this business. We have been in this business for the last 15 years. I believe this is a business about mentoring entrepreneurs, mentoring management teams, and achieving some disproportionate growth in food business, in fashion business, and rural distribution business. We have made significant investments. Most of the companies are doing phenomenally well. Every investment which we have made is into sectors which are growing at the rate of more than 10-15% overall. Our businesses in the companies which we have invested are growing nearly 30-50%. So I think we have made our best efforts. Our job is to explain to the markets. And it'll be a journey.
Okay. But let me look at the flip side of what the criticism is. The criticism is that Kishore Biyani is investing in interesting businesses, but he's raising money to invest in other businesses. Why would average retail investor want to be part of this? I mean, what would you say to someone?
I think my job is to do what I know the best. I think markets will have to, they know what they do the best. I believe the businesses of FMCG food is the most interesting business. As a consumer sector player, I understand what is the next level of consumption which will happen. India's economy is around $1.5 trillion. It will, before the end of this decade, will become more than $3 trillion, and the consumption economy will become $1 trillion. And when a consumption economy grows from $400 billion to $1 trillion, there will be new categories which will come about. There will be new consumption patterns which will emerge. So we are investing in that consumption themes. And we believe that will have phenomenal growth and it will create phenomenal value. I think the expectations are that today you invest and you should get return tomorrow. I think this expectation is something which I'm not able to meet.
But tell me, when you look at this, I mean, one criticism is also they're not making cash profit. But is that a wrong way of looking at these businesses?
But I think it's a wrong assumption, because all our fashion businesses are making money which are older. There are new joint ventures which are done, like Celio, which will get into money by this year or probably by next year. And any new businesses would take a little while time, but most of the businesses like Indus League, Biba, and I think these are all businesses which are
the concern is more around the food brands and the rural distribution channels that you have.
I think 500 crores should be our FMCG business this year, and that is our economic interest play, and I think that's a significant FMCG food business, and as we scale up, I think this business will be highly profitable.
You know, last time I spoke with you, you said you were hoping to raise about 1,000 to 1,200 crores to the Future Ventures IPO. This is 750. So would you need more cash over a period of time? I mean, how are you viewing it?
I think it's not about, it depends on what capital and resources you have, and accordingly you make your investment plans. So we are working on building up mega food parks. That will be an interesting business which we are doing. We can also raise cash by selling off some of our businesses. So I think cash is available, because we have a portfolio of brands, we have a portfolio of companies, and we can look at exit options also.
You know, exit options is interesting, because by its very nature, a VC fund, you know, bets on ideas where there is a clear exit route in terms of an IPO, in terms of, you know, a stake sale, etc. How are you viewing it? Because as you said, you've got an interesting portfolio of investments in Future Ventures. I mean, what's the time frame that you're looking at where each of these ventures, if they're making such cash profits, can be, you know, hived off?
Our first principle of disinvestment would be, or exiting any business would be, when we believe the growth rate is now touching the economic growth rate. So we believe till the time it has disproportionate growth rate than the industry growth rate, I think we would love to be invested in. And unless there is a value which we believe, we cannot create more than what value we are getting from somebody.
But that's a long haul.
I don't think so. Some of our businesses are quite interesting.
Yeah.
If you say, I would say we have a lot of brands which we believe we can get some disproportionate value today also.
No, but I'm saying the flip side. I'm saying that if you're growing 40%, 50%, to see it grow at the economy's rate, which is about 10%, means that you scaled up so much that it is almost in sync with the economy. I'm saying that could be a long-drawn process, wouldn't it?
That is predicated by scale. That was one thing, and secondly was whether we can, if we can get value of tomorrow today, I think it will be very similar to what we'll be doing. So it both are the exit options for us. Third exit option is always IPOing a large company in which you have invested in.
But that is a possibility right now.
Everything is a possibility.
Big Bazaar was the other idea that you were looking at IPOing and saying that there is a possibility of IPOing. It wouldn't be there as a separate entity?
We have it as our 100% subsidiary now. So the option is always open, but that's not what we are looking at this moment.
The other criticism is that both Pantaloons and Future Capital haven't really done well in the market. So, I mean, the metrics for investors to use has been a little flawed because both these stocks are way off the highs. In Future Capital also, the timing was really bad, but a lot of interesting developments have been there. So, I mean, in a sense, is it because the retail as a format is a slow burn, long-term return kind of a format that you're facing this problem? Or do you think, the concerns on debt, etc. are justified right?
I think we have a balance sheet in which we have many businesses and we have investments in other businesses. I think if you look at our investments, today we have investments in Future Capital Holdings. We have an investment in our supply chain logistic business. We have an investment in e-commerce business. We have an investment in Staples, joint venture of office supplies distribution business. We have an investment in life insurance, general insurance. And we have two joint ventures with NTC in two mills in Bombay. So broadly, these are our investments. I believe at a very conservative estimate, these investments can be valued to equal to the debt in the company. So if I can sell off these investments, we become debt free. But there are regulatory challenges, there are other issues.
Is the problem the too many ideas that have been generated, and generated from your office?
I think
there's this rapidity of new ventures, all of which means money investments, right?
I think ideas don't need money. The money follows ideas. That's the way I look at it. And probably, I think it's in one balance sheet, yes. Our retail business is growing significantly. Let's look at our retail formats. Pantaloons should be 2,000 crores of revenue this year. Central Bend Factory, 2,000 crores of revenue this year. Big Bazaar and Food Bazaar should be 8,500 crores plus of revenues this year. Planet Sports, 200 crores plus of revenues this year. So, significant businesses. Hometown should be close to 800, 900 crores, and E-Zone should be around 700, 800 crores of revenue.
And in each, you've expanded, rapidly, which means that you have also got investments out there, which you have to make to expand rapidly. Because you've always said scale is going to be the biggest.
Our base is there now. The capital employed is not as much as what it used to be earlier. Most of the building blocks are in place.
So are you saying from here, incrementally, your expenditure will gradually come down because
definitely, you've scaled? Yes. And secondly, the benefits do come in. If you open in Bombay, if you have around 20 large stores and you open another 3, so the marketing cost, administration cost, HO cost definitely comes down. So your base level effect and efficiency starts creeping in.
So it's happening right now. Over the next couple of years, you see that end becoming far better?
Yeah, feeling quite comfortable on that space in terms of growth. Secondly, I think the same store sales growth have started coming in double-digit numbers and big double-digit numbers. And that's a very interesting trend. Third big trend which is happening in retail is the average selling price is increasing. On an average, I would say our average selling price has increased by 12-15%. So that's another good sign for a retailer because your per square foot productivity goes up. And in that sense, all the other economic indices of the retail format starts looking good.